Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. My name is Amy. If you are new here, then thank you for stopping and checking out this video. I am gonna do something kind of fun today, or I think it's fun. Hopefully you guys will think it's fun too. Also, if my background and this looks weird, I'm testing things out. I'm trying things, and maybe things aren't working out that well, but we'll make it work. So today we're going to be talking about some wants and some won'ts. And I don't know if that's a great name for this, but basically I'm going to be talking about some new makeup releases, some of which are already out, some of which are coming soon. And I'm just going to tell you guys, like, do I want to buy them or is this something I will not purchase? I haven't purchased anything on this list, even the wants, the things that I might enjoy having, but I'm going to tell you why I'm interested, why I'm not interested, and give you all the details. We made a list. I have 7 things that I want. She's a needy bitch. And then there are 5 things on my list that I do not want to buy. So we'll start with the want list because 2 of these kind of go together. So first up, the Huda Beauty Faux Filter Skin Stick Foundation. First of all, Huda has the coverage. We all know that. But what really, really sold me on this was I saw this little 2 words that said fragrance free. And I was like, oh my God, they actually listened. And honestly, like, if you want full coverage, the Huda foundation, the liquid, is really good, but I could not stand the fragrance. And I know that I'm not alone. That is something that has been harped on and harped on. So I won't go on and on about it, but I'm just going to be honest. That really sold me on it because sometimes I want really full coverage foundation and I'm just not willing to use it. I have it in my collection. I've even tried like mixing a little bit of it with something else to, you know, kind of heighten the coverage, but hopefully not the fragrance, and still it's so, so strong. So this stick foundation comes in 39 shades. It looks like a really good range, and honestly I'm usually pretty happy with Huda products. There's only been a couple of things that I haven't really liked, and most of the time it's just because they're chock full of fragrance. So this one I am really, really excited to kind of try out, and I may go ahead and purchase this really soon. I think there might be a Sephora sale coming up, so I might have to take advantage of that. And kind of in conjunction with that, I'm gonna go ahead and do 2 on this list, is the Huda Water Jelly Hydrating Primer. Now this, to me, looks kind of basic, but I'm also really, really intrigued. So this one's supposed to be ultra hydrating, and it is supposed to grip makeup in place. That makes me think of like the Milk Makeup, you know, gripping primer, but it's intriguing enough for me to want to try them together. Like, I would be very, very tempted to get the primer and the foundation. It looks really, really good. So that one goes for $33. The foundation goes for $39. And now I did read somewhere that it's like not very much in the stick, but I don't know about you guys. Personally, I feel like when I have a stick foundation, I don't really go through it that fast. Granted, I'm always switching up my foundation, but I don't feel like I have to use a lot more of it. If anything, I might use less. So I'm at least intrigued enough to try it out and see what happens. Let me know if you want to review if I happen to get it. I'm gonna go back and forth. So we'll do the good and the bad. We'll mix it together. The first up on the will not buy list is the XX Revolution. Now, first of all, can anybody else just tell me why it's Revolution Beauty, iHeart Revolution, XX Revolution? It's like literally the same makeup line, and they have all these like other brand names. I don't know why that bothers me, but just be like Revolution Beauty or iHeart Revolution. Just pick one, you know, because this one's now XX Revolution, and this is the Metallics collection. It has a palette, a mask, 2 elixirs, a mist, and the Luxe Suspension. Well, I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you guys, I'm looking at this picture right here, and first of all, this looks like 2 shades of Body Lava, like straight up repeat. The spray looks like the iconic London setting spray. The thing I don't like is that a lot of what Revolution does is just like copying other brands. Let me know how you guys feel about that. When a brand is basically like duping something, do you like it because you can get something that's maybe too expensive for you in an affordable option, or do you feel like they're just ripping off all the other brands? To me, I don't like it. Now, it's just something about it, like especially when you're just going straight in for it. Now, I have some Revolution products that to my knowledge are not like, you know, copies. They really are something a little bit different. That's like the Tasty Avocado palette. They have like popcorn hot dog. I thought they were really fun and cute. I still haven't even used them all. Like, I bought a bunch of them. They're really affordable, and it wasn't like copying Glamlight, even though Glamlight did like the food stuff maybe before that, but it wasn't like a hamburger palette, you know. But this, This looks like Body Lava from Fenty. It looks like Iconic London. The palette, I don't know what it's supposed to look like. It looks like a few different things that I've seen, but it's just gold. I'm just over their launches. Like, the Friend stuff was kind of cute. But once again, was that Revolution Beauty or I Heart Revolution or what? I just wish they would stick to one name. Is that too much to ask? Like, I'm just gonna stick with my name. Can you stick to yours? Okay. I know I'm being nitpicky. I'm gonna stop. Now, next up, a brand that I really love their shadows is Juvia's Place. I feel like their eyeshadows are phenomenal, and they have some new collections you can get. Now, last time I checked, right after it launched, a lot of it was sold out, but I'm definitely keeping my eye open because I think I need it. But it is the Nubian Glow and Nubian Royal set. So each of these sets comes with a palette and then two lip products, but I'm just looking at the palettes. I'm looking, like, each of the sets is only 26. That's a palette and two lip products, but you can get these palettes on their own, and I think they run like $15, like something super, super affordable. But the colors, like in the Nubian Royal set, that like purple blue really calls to me. It looks so rich, and I know how these shadows are going to perform. And I have probably 4, 5, maybe 6 Juvia's Place palettes, because I have tiny ones and then bigger ones, and they never, ever, ever disappoint. Like, I can always depend on that those shadows are going to do well. I'm a big fan of Juvia's Place as far as all the products go. I love it. I love it. I need it. And both of these look really, really good. I have 2 palettes that are this size, and just because the size is smaller does not mean it skimps on the quality. Some brands tend to be like that. Like, they put out little, you know, palettes here and there, and they're not as good as their full size palettes, but I have not had that experience with Juvia's Place. So these are definitely on my want list. Next up, I'm going to pop up a picture of the Kylie, what is it? Leopard collection. Now, I love me some leopard print, don't get me wrong, and some of this is cute. I don't really like her, like, I don't know, posing all over the packaging, but that's just me. Now, I'm not a hater of, like, the Kardashian Jenner stuff. Like, I'm not a hater, but I'm also not interested, and I just feel like there's so many people supporting them already that, like, they don't need my support. You know what I mean? I have never purchased a Kylie product. I do have the cleanser. It tore my skin up, like, red, inflamed. It was bad. I actually poured out and recycled the bottle like a few days ago. And this collection does look kind of cute, don't get me wrong. Like, there's nothing wrong with it. I don't want to really support them. Like, I don't feel like it's anything that special. And I don't know, is that just me? Like, do you guys buy from Kylie and Kim and, you know, all of their brands? I'm just not a big fan. That is not to show, like, any hate on this, but from what I'm seeing, like, the palette is kind of cute. It looks like neutral with a couple pop of colors, nothing special. It definitely has, like, all of the ColourPop components, like the lipsticks, the glosses that are, like, a shorter, everything looks like ColourPop, which I know people have talked about. They're in the same lab, so maybe a lot of things are the same, but I don't know. I'm just not a fan. I don't really, like, throw my support that way. Now, let's talk about something really affordable, because I just ordered the e.l.f. Trend Mood Box, which I'm really excited, but it's mostly skincare. And e.l.f. has a new product that is their Putty Blush. These are only $6. As you'll see in the picture, there are 8 shades. And I have to say, lately, everything I've been trying from e.l.f. I've been really impressed about. I've been using their hydrating concealer and all of the poreless, luminous, and matte primers. I have all of those, the putty primers, and I think they're really good, which makes me want to try this blush even more. And I've been getting into using some more, like, creams and liquid products on a regular basis, where normally, like, it's foundation, concealer, and set my whole face, and everything else is powder. But I'm kind of getting into it, and I feel like a putty blush could be a really, really nice option. But I also love, if I pick up a couple of these, like, it's $12, and if I don't like them, it's only $12, so it's not that bad. Okay, I'm not gonna spend a lot of time talking about this because it's all the same blah reasons as the Kylie stuff, but the KKW Opalescent Collection. We've got a palette and semi-matte lips. There are 8 shades. Now, they have a vault where you can get all 8 for $166. I just don't want it. So $22 a piece for the lips, $45 for the palette. First of all, the palette has 10 shades, and it doesn't really call to me. It looks like a couple of colors and then a face palette. So I'm not really feeling that. Like, they look like highlighters. It doesn't look like anything special. Now, that middle shade, that one color that's like purple dark blue, kind of wants to be that Juvia's Place shade, but I just don't trust that it would be anything that special. And I mean, it's not bad, but once again, I don't need to support Kim Kardashian. Like, I think we're good. Okay, so I know I'm trying to lose my voice. Please ignore that, but we have a few more products. Another thing that I'd like to pick up is the Milani Cheek Kiss Cream Blush. Now, another cream blush, but I think it would be really fun to try both and see which one is better. Now, these are $9 and there is only 4 shades. Now, only a couple of the shades really call to me. However, I know that those darker, brighter shades might look great on my skin too, just used sparingly. But I feel like if I had to choose, I would probably pick the e.l.f. ones and try them because they're less expensive and there's more shades. But $9, I mean, I feel like I could definitely give these a try. And Milani blushes are some of my favorite blushes, like the powder ones. I love them. So yeah, I feel like this would be a really fun product to try. All right, next up, the ColourPop Stone Cold Fox palette for $34 is a will not purchase category. Now, this palette I do think is really pretty. It's got cool neutrals in it and it looks gorgeous, but I just feel like we all have these colors in our palettes. Like, if you have any type of a collection, if you have 10, 20 palettes, you probably have all of these shades, unless you're someone who really, really loves warm tones. Like, I don't know, I'm not really feeling these warm tones I have on today, so this palette kind of like is this palette's kind of speaking to me in a way right now because I do love those type of tones, but I don't know. I just feel like it's a little bit ordinary. It's $34. Now, ColourPop has some really, really pretty stuff, and I love ColourPop. I am going to try my hardest to get the Baby Yoda palette tomorrow, but this is just a palette that is like your neutral, cool tones. Granted, if you don't have this in your collection and maybe you only have a few palettes, this might be a wonderful thing to add to your collection, but I cannot in good conscience spend any money on any palettes because I have so many. Like, even buying the little Baby Yoda one is really not something I should be doing, but at least it's something a little bit different. But I can't buy a neutral palette with my own money right now. Like, I just can't. I have too many. I will do a palette declutter really soon and you guys will see like the horror that is my collection, and I promise you will be like, bitch, you don't need to buy a palette ever again. So I just said some stuff and now I'm gonna have to like take it back and eat my words and try to like walk around that whole phrase that I just used, that I don't need to spend money on palettes, because I would love to have this Natasha Denona Triochrome palette, but this is kind of like, it's a want, but a won't, but a want, but a won't. Like, I keep going back and forth because it is gorgeous. It has some duochrome shades. The swatches look great on all 3 skin tones, which I love. And I was totally on board with this until I realized it is one of the full-size big pan palettes for $129. Now, for some people, if this is going to be like your color story, by all means. But I love their smaller palettes, like the Sunrise. I think it was the Sunrise that was the red that was smaller. You still have the same amount of colors and they're just in smaller pans. That's like perfect for me. So that kind of made me like stop, but I do think this is beautiful. And this is the one like eyeshadow palette brand that I will splurge and spend a ton of money on. I have not tried a lot of Pat McGrath. Like, I probably should, and I'll probably be like addicted to hers as well. But as of right now, like, I love my Natasha Denona and I feel like it's my big splurge on makeup. So I really do love this palette. I just wish it was the smaller pans. So way to go for lack of clarity there. I love when I do that. So we have one more thing on my list that I will not buy. Period, point blank, will not buy. It is the Morphe and Nikita Dragon collab. I don't know. You guys weigh in. I'm genuinely curious to see what you guys think about this collection. And just to be clear too, like, if you guys want to buy any of these stuff I don't want to buy, I totally support that and I'm cool with it. Like, I don't take any offense if you guys like disagree with me. Hopefully you guys don't either. I fully support everyone just getting what they want and doing what they want. But for me, this is it's a no for me, dog. You know what I'm saying? So first of all, this palette is not the worst thing in the world, but the color story does not speak to me. It's kind of all over the place. I see a row of neutrals, a row of like reds, And then you've got like these random ass pops of color. The palette goes for $30. The brush set is $20. The brush set does not appeal to me. Like, their brushes aren't the worst, but they're not the best. But I don't like the packaging. I don't like the handles. It's just really not my thing. And then they're like, oh, by the way, here's these like best sellers from Nikita Dragon's brand. I have never ever cared about Dragon Beauty. I'm almost to the end, I swear. So when I was in high school, we had a word for people that just were kind of like always stirring stuff up and maybe being too dramatic or getting into this and that. And we just called them messy. You know, when somebody's messy, she's messy. And it's just not appealing to me. Like back way, way back in the day when she was like a little bit more down to earth, I was like, oh, she, you know, she's really interesting. Her story is super endearing. Then it went too far for me. I don't like the whole demeanor and attitude and some stuff she's been doing on Twitter. I'm just like, oh, let me stay away from that. The one tweet that I'll tell you guys about said, what race will I be today? And I was like, okay, well, if I didn't not like her already, I definitely don't like her now. That was just a little bit too much for me. But I don't know. Let me know how you guys feel. I feel like her brand is just nothing to me. Like I've never found any interest in the products, and maybe they're just not suited for me, and that's totally fine. If you like them, like, more power to you. But you know, it's just messy. Okay, so finally, one more product I have to tell you about, and that is the Kimchi Bronzer. Now, I think these are super, super cute. There are 6 colors, and they only go for $15 a piece. I think that's pretty reasonable. I've heard nothing but, like, really good things about Kimchi, but let me know, like, if you guys tried anything. I've not tried anything from the brand, and I've kind of been waiting on something to, like, speak to me, and I think these are super cute. They're, like, in a little heart-shaped packaging, really affordable, and I think there's a pretty decent color range as well. I'm looking at that fair shade thinking like, ooh, that could be a really, really good bronzer. So I'm definitely interested in trying that out. And it would be my first time trying the brand in general. So I feel like that's maybe why that particular launch is more intriguing for me, is because I haven't tried it before. I haven't tried the brand. So that is it for this video. I had 7 wants and 5 wants. Yeah, I gotta come up with a new name for that. But let me know, do you guys like these? I mean, there are so many makeup launches that this could probably be a weekly occurrence. If you guys want to see more of these where I'm just talking about new launches, hopefully I don't lose my voice every time. So yeah, let me know what you guys think. If you want to see more videos like this, then let me know in the comments below. Also weigh in, tell me like what's on your list to buy or not buy. I want to know. And I hope you guys enjoyed hanging with me and chit chatting. If you are not already subscribed, be sure to subscribe to my channel and also hit that notification bell so that maybe you can find out when I upload videos. But definitely leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye!